Hello students, welcome to the class. And in this class on current affairs, I will be dealing with the 15th Finance Commission's term of reference. Now, first of all, we need to understand what is the role of Finance Commission in a country like India. Now, Finance Commission's primary purpose is to recommend to the government how the resources should be divided between the central government and the state governments, how the distribution of the resources should actually be taking place. This is the basic mandate that we have conferred to the Finance Commission. This is the purpose because of which we are having Finance Commission in India, and we have also accorded the constitutional status to the Finance Commission. Now, the distribution of the resources between the center and the state, how this distribution should be done? Now, this is the basic question that the Finance Commission answers for every 5 years. Now, this 15th Finance Commission that is headed by N.K. Singh, it will be deciding about that for a period for 2020 onwards till 2025, how this resource distribution should be done. What should be the basis of the distribution? Now, in order to understand this, we need to understand federalism in India. And we also need to understand the seventh schedule of the Indian Constitution. Now, when it comes to the seventh schedule of the Indian Constitution, it has bifurcated the subjects, like we have the central list, we have the state list, and we have the concurrent list. We are having three lists, and these lists confer the specific role onto the states, onto the center, that what role they should actually be performing. Now, if we look at the parameters, like the parameter of the human development, the parameter of education, the parameter of health, and the parameter of irrigation and agriculture. Now, all these parameters, they constitute core of the development of how the development should be carried out in India. Agar Hindustan mein development karna hai, we need to actually focus on health, education, agriculture, irrigation, etc., etc. And all these subjects, they basically fall in the state list. Now, because they fall in the state list, they have the responsibility to do these very functions which form the foundation of development. They must also have access to the finance. So, the finance that they should be getting, it should be done on the principle of equity. There should be equitable distribution of the finances. Now, in Indian context, the federalism, the way it is working in India, the federal units, they are independent in themselves. Ka kya matlab hai ki wo khud kuch bhi kare, क्योंकि उनको हमने ऑलरेडी मैंडेट दिया हुआ है स्टेट लिस्ट में. स्टेट लिस्ट में वट एवर द स्टेट शुड बी डूइंग, दे शुड बी अलाउड टू दैट बिकॉज दे हैव देयर ओन इंडिपेंडेंट इलेक्टेड गवर्नमेंट्स. वन शुड नॉट इम्पोज दैट वट दे शुड बी डूइंग. नाउ हाउ द स्टेट शुड बी फंक्शनिंग, इट शुड नॉट बी गाइडेड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. एंड द फाइनेंसेस दैट दे should be getting, it should not be decided by the standards, it should not be decided by the yardstick that should be created by the Finance Commission. Rather, the distribution of the finances should be on the principle of equity. Now, states us paise se kuch bhi kare, states us paise se development jis tarah wo karna chahe us hisab se kare, kyunki people have elected the state governments. But the way the Finance Commissions work in India, they actually impose conditions on the administration, of how the administration should be carried out. Those standards which are basically decided by the Finance Commission, they actually also become condition, those standards also become the conditions because of which the states, they have access to the finances. If they will not be achieving those standards, they will not be getting the finance from the central government. Now, such kind of functioning of the Finance Commission, it actually goes against the principle of how federalism is carried out, how the relationship between this citizen and the state government be maintained. So, citizen or center ke beech mein jo relationship hai, wo relationship effectively maintain nahi ho payega. Kyun wo relationship maintain nahi ho payega? Kyun? Because citizens ne state government ko chuna hai, aur state government kis tarah function kare ye kon decide kar raha hai? Center. Finances kyunki center de raha hai. So this is creating a big trouble. Now, the recently constituted 15th Finance Commission, the term of references, it has become a big issue. It has become a big issue of debate and discussion, and also of dispute between the central government and the state governments. Like I have told you, the finances are to be decided, or distribution has to be decided by the Finance Commission. And the recently constituted has been asked to bring about a change in the year, that is from 1971, the year has been changed to 2011 as the reference period, as the census period, because population will also be a criteria. Jis state ka zyada population hai, usko zyada paisa milega center se. Distribution is hisab se hoga. Secondly, the distribution jis hisab se hoga, it will be decided by ki center ka core expenditure kya hai. Ek baar center ka expenditure decide ho jayega, uske baad mein jo paisa bacha hoga, wo states mein distribute hoga. And ek term of reference ye bhi hai, jo kehta hai ki state government ka jo revenue deficit hai, usko kam karne ke liye, jo revenue part of expenditure hai, usko kaise kam karna hai. And another term of reference is about focusing on performance parameters. Ki performance ke parameters aur decide kare, agar states un parameters ko meet karega, tabhi usko paisa milega. Dekhiye, ye conditions laga raha hai, kaun laga raha hai ye conditions? Ye Finance Commission's condition laga raha hai. Federal principle should not work on the principle of conditions. Rather, it should be working on the principle of equity. So, the present Finance Commission that is actually working for the period 2020 and 25 is working on imposing conditions. Imposing conditions will kill democracy. Imposing conditions will kill federalism. Imposing condition will kill governance. Imposing conditions will kill administration. So, that will actually hurt the relationship that the citizen hold with the state governments, and the relationship that the state governments are currently holding with the central government, it will also undergo a change if the recommendations of the 15th Finance Commission will be implemented whenever they will be released, because the basis of these recommendations will certainly be the terms of the references. So this was all for the day. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is Brainy IAS. And you can also visit our website brainyias.com. We are launching a new pattern of providing current affair to the aspirants. So you can visit the website to have a look at that. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.